What's happening, everybody? Welcome back to Sporgo, and today we're going to talk about this cub, or pet as we used to call it, that Cruel Games gave us during this update. This thing is actually quite insane, especially teamed up with characters that have stuns, like good old Kamui here, which I'm going to show you today, guys. It's actually quite nutty that you're pretty much going to have an infinite stun with this cub. So let's talk about it, guys. This cub's actually a pretty cool pet. Now, the first thing, guys, is I wouldn't level this thing up. And I'll talk about why here in a little bit. But the first thing that you're going to unlock is this active skill 1. And you actually can choose between these things here. Now, because it's equipped to Kamui, who is a dark character, it's automatically going to, you know, increase our dark damage, give us a 2-second stun, or increase our dark damage by a smaller amount and give us a 5-second stun. 5-second stun is honestly way more valuable than this little bit of extra damage, in my opinion. And the way to operate this thing, the way to proc it more or less, to bring it in and do the stun, is you want to be doing 6 blue or 6 yellow orbs. So if you do 6 yellow, or if you do 6 blue orbs, or if you do 3 blue and 3 yellow, you will proc this thing. You will be able to bring, you're not really procing it because you have to manually bring it in, but it'll be ready to proc and you can actually bring it in and do that stun. It's actually quite insane, and no matter what character you put it on. So for example, just like I said a second ago, I have it equipped to Kamui right now, who is a dark character. If I equip to Fire God Lee, you'll notice that this thing will change to fire. So now it's showing fire damage. Still gonna have the 5-second stun. This doesn't change at all. I'm gonna go ahead and slap it back on my Kamui because I actually like having it on him. I'm having a lot of fun using this on him because Kamui actually has built-in stuns in his kit. In fact, both versions of Kamui actually have stuns built into the kit. Now, as you level up this cub, you're going to unlock more and more things that are going to add to the damage or even certain effects for your characters, right? Which is going to be very, very valuable in the future. Not so much with this particular cub, because again, guys, you don't really want to level this thing up. You will find there's going to be a material that will bottleneck you, and it's just going to be very, very hard to level up S rank pets, which is really what you want to focus your materials on. You don't want to focus it on this. You just want to use that 5-second stun, and that's pretty much it. If you want to level it up, by all means, you can. You can do that if you want. But the way to level this thing up, guys, is you're going to use these materials here. Now, you can acquire these materials from the Norman, but really the best place to get these materials is actually from the Echo Area event. I mean, this is where you're going to be getting all these sweet, sweet, wonderful materials, and you can acquire them pretty fast. You can also get the materials from the resources here. If you go into resources and you go all the way to the end, you can get those materials in here as well. Really, you're going to get the most materials when you go all the way to the end, but you get the idea, right? And on top of that, when you evolve them, you're going to need shards, just like what you do with your characters, right? You can actually farm for shards for this particular cub if you want to. And the way to get shards for him, or for it, is I guess what I should say, is actually from Norman. So in Norman, these ores are what's going to allow you to get those shards. When you go into shop, these shards are going to be able to level that cub up. And once you have 30 of these shards, which is going to take an insane amount of these ores, because you need 50,000 ores for just one shard. You need 30 of them to take him to S rank, or take, I don't want to say him, but to take it to S rank, right? So it's a lot. Again, guys, I would not advise leveling it up. And when you do level this thing up, you're going to unlock more skills, right? You got available skill 1 right now, and when you ever take it to S rank, you'll get your skill 2, which means you'll get the next skill, which is this one right here, right? The higher rank you unlock, the more effects you're going to unlock from your pet. So when I click on this, you see it says it needs to be S rank to unlock. When I click on this, it needs to be SS to unlock, right? Triple S, and then hit this one here is triple S plus, right? So for future pets, this is going to be a big, big deal. Not really so much for this one right here. And you can also, of course, level it up with dupes, just like we can with our characters, because they give you shards. And then with the skill, guys, this is the bottleneck of these cubs or pets. Is this material right here, the support skill components. This is a random level upper, guys. So when you hit level up, it randomly levels up one of these. What ends up happening for most players is you just end up maxing all of this, and it takes a ridiculous amount of resources, a ridiculous amount of these things, guys, to level to level these things up. It really does. And this is the main reason why you really don't want to level up this pet. You want to use the pet because, I mean, Fire Sand is done. It's just amazing, guys. It's so good. Such a great form of CC against multitude of bosses. Bosses like Rosetta and Norman who jump around and fly up in the air all the time. Whenever they get a stun on them, a 5-second stun, that allows you to do a ton of damage to them, not to mention increasing your survivability because you're not taking any kind of damage from them because they're not attacking you. It is actually a really awesome cub. I keep wanting to call it a pet, but cub is what they call it. And then you have the story, and as you unlock it, guys, you go to S Ring, they'll unlock a little bit more of the story, and so on and so on and so on. Again, guys, you don't need to level this thing up. I'm not going to level this thing up beyond level 10. I'm just going to save these materials for an S rank character. Now, again, as far as using the cub, you just want to use, you know, 3 yellow or 3 blue or 6 yellow and 6 blue in order to trigger this thing. So if we come into training stage, we go into combat training here, and we bring in Kamui. I'll show you guys what he can do. Let me grab my controller here. All right, so this is nice, guys. This is nice. So we got 3 blue and 2 yellow, right? Okay, so I'll hit my yellow, right? We'll hit my blue, and there you guys can see the little icon here. Now, what happens is, eventually, this pet's icon is actually going to move up in this area right here. But for now, with this pet, what they've done is they just move your orbs to the left one slot, and they throw in this right here. And whenever you use this thing, watch this. And there's that sweet stun. Look at that. 5-second stun that you can use. Again, guys, 3 yellow and 3 blue or 6 yellow and 6 blue in order to trigger that thing. And with a character like Kamui or Tenebrian, this guy right here, or Kamui Bastion, you can pretty much have almost an infinite stun, guys. Like, you can literally equip this cub to a character that has a bunch of stuns, or if this character's on a team already. So, for example, like for my dark team, I could easily put that cub on Luna, who does 3 pings over and over and over. You know, whenever she does a 3-ping, she procs another 3-ping, right? Which means it's going to be a very, very easy to be able to use a stun that cub with a character like her. It's actually a really awesome tool that we can use to take down bosses, to take down phantom pain cages. I mean, this is really nice, guys. Like, this Polyphage here, which is a new boss, by the way, actually can get stunned. This character can get stunned, and I believe Nozzle can get stunned as well, guys. So, I mean, having that 5-second stun is really, really going to help to do a bunch of damage. So I'm just going to leave you guys with a solo run against Nightmare Boss Rosetta, showing pretty much an infinite stun solo with my boy Kamui here. So guys, let me know what you think about this cub, and I do stream on Twitch at 9 p.m. GT plus 7 time. The link is in the description below, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching. Y'all take care and have a good one. See everybody.